Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's an absolute pleasure and honor being with you all here today. And I'd like to start by doing a quick pulse check, just to make sure that everyone here believes what I believe and that we can actually have a good conversation. Who here thinks that artificial intelligence is important for the future? Everyone in the room, perfect. Who here thinks that artificial intelligence will impact their lives directly today? Okay, less people than the ones that answered the first time. I'd like to start by making a statement, but following up to the conversation of His Excellency Minister Asayeh, which is, there is a new world order that is going to come together because of artificial intelligence, quantum computing, big data, and all these technologies. But there is also a new world disorder that will be coming for countries and nations and cities that do not adopt these technologies. So it is important for us to be part of the revolution. It is important for us to create opportunities because of these technologies. Before talking about the future and the UAE artificial intelligence strategy, I'd like to use a quote from the late Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan to guide us when it comes to looking at the future of artificial intelligence. His Highness said, "He who does not know his past will not know his present and his future." And it is important for us to know our past before we derive the vision that we're going to create for the future. Our past in the year 813 was that we were a civilization that created science, technology, innovation, and culture and exported it to the rest of the world. From the year 813 till the year 1515, the Middle East was at the cutting edge and at the pinnacle of technology and the forefront of change. Something happened in the year 1515 that changed all of that. Something happened that took us from being at the forefront to, unfortunately, being followers and laggards today. And that was a technology. In the year 1455, a technology was invented that had the promise to revolutionize the world as we know it. That technology was welcomed by every civilization on the planet. It was the reason for the Renaissance in Europe, and it was the reason for the development in Asia. The only civilization on Earth that banned this technology was the Muslim and Arab civilization in the Middle East. It was the Gutenberg printing press that brought a new way of thinking and spread science and knowledge to the world. It was the first internet that reinvented the human mind. Today, we are in the year 813 again. And today, we have a technology that is as influential and as important as the Gutenberg printing press. What we do with it is going to decide whether we are part of the new world order or that there's a new disorder that will be a part of our future. The UAE artificial intelligence strategy comes with this in mind. It comes with lessons from the past and also visions for the future that we need to put for ourselves and for us to actually achieve. Some may say that the UAE might not have what it takes to lead the artificial intelligence revolution globally. And to those I say, you need to look at sectors such as logistics, tourism, infrastructure, and air travel to understand that the UAE does not just say certain things, but it makes it happen. We did not invent the airplane. We did not invent maritime trade. We did not invent tourism. And we did not have any of the fundamental cornerstones to make the UAE a leader in these sectors. But today, because of the vision and because of the drive of our leadership, we were able to become global leaders in these sectors. Our strategy revolves around that. It revolves around making the UAE one of the leading countries in artificial intelligence in the next 10 years. There is 1 month left to the end of the year. But why this month makes a difference is because it ends the decade. And we enter into a new decade, the decade of the digital revolution and the decade of artificial intelligence. The UAE has certain benefits that makes it a lot more prone to be a leader in artificial intelligence than many other countries. We have 200 nationalities living and thriving on this land. And if you understand anything about artificial intelligence, you understand that artificial intelligence lives on data. And the importance of data is three V's. The volume of data, the velocity of data, so how fast this data can be accessed, and the variety of data. These 200 nationalities give us the variety. We have the most diverse data set on the planet, and no other country can compare. When it comes to volume of data, the UAE has platforms that are local but operate globally. Just look at our port operators, DP World. It's a port operator that came out of the UAE but operates 68 ports around the world. The data set that they have is more valuable than any other port data set on the planet. And the same can be said about Etihad Airlines and Emirates Airlines, which operate to more than 166 destinations around the world, the biggest airline in the world. These airlines have the most unique and most important data set when it comes to air travel. And then finally, when we look at velocity, there has been a long transformation process that the UAE has been going through since the year 2002, which took us from being a traditional government to being an electronic government, a digital government, a mobile government, and then a smart government in 2015. It took many years of planning and implementation to take us from being an old school government to being the government of the future, and a government that can lead in the era of artificial intelligence. Today, we are ready in this transformation process, and we can become the cutting edge country that exports technologies to the rest of the world. To summarize the UAE AI strategy, I'd like to say that the AI strategy revolves around three main foundations. The first is talent and capacity building. We believe that through attracting and retaining the right talent from around the world, the UAE can become the leading country globally when it comes to artificial intelligence. Some of you may ask, why would this talent come to the UAE? And to that I answer, because the UAE offers a unique quality of life. Because we have the mobility that no one else has. You can be in the UAE and access any market in one day of flight. And because the UAE offers a legislative process that is very agile and very flexible. So any experts from around the world can come and deploy their solutions on the ground in the UAE in the most effective manner. We also believe that we need to create homegrown talents. So there are many programs that we launched to empower the youth in the UAE to understand what artificial intelligence is, to also give them the ability to understand if they want to become doctors, lawyers, engineers, or any other sector in the future, what would that mean for them, and how can artificial intelligence support them in their journey? The second part of this is the policy-making framework. In most countries, policies are made, and the private sector and academia and the people that are leading this effort are forced to abide by it. In the UAE, we have more of a consultative approach, where we work with the private sector, we work with academia, and we ensure that everyone is happy with the direction that we're moving in. And then, the most important factor, the responsible deployment and development of artificial intelligence. We are going to deploy artificial intelligence, and we are already deploying artificial intelligence in many key government sector areas. But it's important that we deploy it responsibly. To give you an analogy of why it's important to be responsible when you're looking at artificial intelligence, I'd like to give you a challenge to think about. There is a big problem globally that we all need to combat and face. It is called climate change. And if you look at climate change, it is the result of selfish development of industrial and urban development of certain countries. They did not know that if they move quickly, and if they develop fast, and if they pollute the environment, this is going to lead to climate change being one of the biggest challenges of humanity in this day and age. Even if those countries stop polluting today, climate change will not be solved or fixed. It is important that we all work hand in hand to solve climate change. So it is a global challenge that was started by local players. Artificial intelligence brings the same promise. If we do not develop the technology responsibly, if we do not deploy it in the right and effective manner, we are going to face a challenge because of the digital world that we live in that all of us either have to combat together or we'll all fail together at. So to this, our guiding principle when it comes to artificial intelligence in the UAE is BRAIN, building a responsible artificial intelligence nation. Responsible development and responsible deployment is key. And working with global partners from all around the world is paramount to ensure that we have a positive future when it comes to artificial intelligence. I'd like to leave you with the following statement. Today, we are not in the year 2019. We are in the year 1455 once again. If we look at our history, we're at this point once again. The decisions we make as individuals, as organizations, and countries today are going to shape the future generations of the UAE and the world. I hope that all of you take the right decisions, and I do hope that we can come back and celebrate the decisions that we take collectively together. Thank you very much.